The New York Stock Exchange opened and dove more than 1,000 points with volatile trading in response to the steep drop in Chinese markets and lack of confidence in the leaders of the world's biggest nation.
This is a sell-off that's pretty much made in China. It's a reaction to great uncertainty about the direction of the Chinese economy and whether the Chinese authorities have a handle on how to manage their economy.
At the White House, spokesman Josh Earnest was quick to point out the U.S. economy's stability and that Treasury Secretary Jacob Lew has been in touch with China.
The Treasury Department has been closely monitoring global markets, including those financial markets in China. You've also seen readouts that have been issued by the Treasury Department of conversations that Secretary Lew has had with senior Chinese officials.
Earnest admits much of the talk was focused on currency reforms and encouraging China's efforts to become a more market-based economy. But the economic worries aren't confined to Asia and the U.S. In the Mideast, markets were also down. Dubai dropped nearly 50 points, losing 1.5% of value. The Egyptian stock exchange lost nearly 2%, about 130 points. Experts say this could be the long-rumored correction, a realization that global growth isn't moving as quickly as hoped, with the market overreacting and reaching to find a stable level. They also say it's likely not over yet.
Global markets are in total turmoil. Currency markets are in turmoil. This is just sort of shaken up the status quo. As I said, a lot of investors had sort of counted on a certain amount of stability out of China, and now that's been called into question, and it's really throwing markets around the world into a bit of chaos.
So if China is the root, why the sell-off in oil? Crude prices have been falling, even as OPEC kept production levels high to meet expected demands from Asian economies. Kush Choksi is Vice President for Turkey and Middle East Affairs with the U.S. Chamber of Commerce.
The most pertinent effect, both in the short term and in the medium to longer term, is the fact that a slowdown in the Chinese economy will impact its procurement of oil from the Middle East. China is a major buyer of oil in the Middle East, and any slowdown, given the state of the energy markets as it is, will continue to impact the Middle East.
Mideast nations like Bahrain are better positioned for a downturn, Choksi says, if they used profits from oil to diversify their economies, making them more resilient against market instability. Reporting for Bahrain TV, I'm Marty Johnson, Washington.